doing a budget type of phone with pro grade camera and working at the specs, you might want to look at the Pixel 4a, which released yesterday. And the price of the Pixel 4a has a mystery behind it. Let's watch on. So yesterday, August 3rd, Google have just released its Pixel 4a device. Okay, this video will be a two-part video where I will be talking about the Pixel 4a and also I'll be talking about the Google's future phone, which will be releasing this year, maybe November or December, which is the Pixel 5 and the Pixel 4a. So if you want to skip through that, go to the description and press the timestamp to skip to the 5 information. Okay, the 4a. The 4a is a phone that Google released yesterday, which is August 3rd. So why they have released it on August 3rd? Because August 4th is when OnePlus Nord is going to release. So OnePlus Nord was previously on July 21st, they have just launched the phone. And the phone would come at $400 something or euros. Actually, Pixel 4a was going to be launched at $399 due to the immense competition for the budget price phones. They have lowered the price to $350 or $349. Why? Because at the $399 price point, there is the iPhone SE. To compete with iPhone SE, they have to lower the price point because budget people would go for budget price only. So if they find more lower price than the iPhone SE or any phone that is in the market, they will of course go for the lower price point. These people do not care about the specs, they just want a phone for the lower price. I guess that is why they have lowered the price, because to compete with the iPhone and OnePlus Nord, they have to lower the price to attract the people to buy the 4a. So specs, before talking specs, I won't be talking in detail or bore you with the specs. I'll be only talking brief with specs. In detail, I'll be writing an article on the Pixel 4a specs in detail. Everything will be there in my blog, which is thedailyenterprise.com. So when this video comes out, the blog also will be out. So you can go down to the description and press the link below to read the blog. So the specs, right? It has Snapdragon 730 chipset, which is not so powerful as the 765G chipset. And it has a full view 5.81 inch display. Yes, it is full view, not a notch, not a bar. It's full view with the hole punch cut out at the top corner for the selfie camera. At the back, it has single camera. That's a downside, right? Okay, if you see the box type of thing, you might think it has two cameras. No, it has only single. It has one single camera, also with the flash, of course. Okay, that camera takes a good pro grade photos for your information. Yep, it has 12.1 megapixel camera. That is, and a camera is a good pro grade camera. Okay, that camera is the same camera with the premium phone, which is the Pixel 4. So it's having the same lens, same camera with the Pixel 4a. And if you don't know, Google's image processing or image software is optimized for giving out the best images in the market. Speaking of the selfie camera takes a good selfies, one thing. And overall, this phone is good. It's a good phone. The back of the phone is a plastic back. So of course the price is also budget, so you have to go for the budget materials. One thing is that this phone comes in one color, one spec, and one single phone. It comes in 6GB RAM with 128GB storage, only in black color. That's a big bummer, right? Why they have gone for one color? Because of the COVID-19, of course, because they cannot build more colors. That's what they have told. I don't know. Let's talk about which phone you have to buy for this price: iPhone SE, OnePlus Nord, or the Pixel 4a. If you want a pro grade camera, good performance in the phone, and a good build quality. Go for the iPhone SE. It has everything you, that you want. If you want a quad camera setup, good build quality, a good amount of screen, fast performance, everything, go for the OnePlus Nord. It's having a 90Hz refresh rate, smooth screen, everything is good. And if you want a pro grade camera, not so okay specs, go for the 4A. Actually, 4A is a phone that I would prefer as a secondary phone, as a casual phone. So if you want a phone that you don't want to use at all times, or just a casual phone, you can go for the 4A. It's a perfect casual phone. Let's leave that aside. Now let's go to the 4A 5G and the Pixel 5. Okay, at this launch event, Google have just given a poster on the 4A 5G and Pixel 5. This is the poster. Here, where the 5 is written, so if you see closely, it is having a ceramic designish type. So the phone next to the 5 is also having ceramic design type at the rails. That is the Pixel 5. One thing that comes to my mind is that it would be a premium phone. And if you see the camera bump, if you zoom it, the camera bump on the Pixel 5 is way thinner than the 4A. And next to it, the 5G, right? That is the 4A 5G. That's a maxed out or excel version of 4A. And yeah, it's having 5G capability. So they cannot go for Snapdragon 730 chipset because that is not having 5G modem in that. I think they would go for the 760 5G chipset because that is having 5G modem, which is the same chipset with the OnePlus Nord. This phone comes in the fall. The fall maybe at the time of November or December, at that time it would launch. And the launch event would be, I guess it would be in the time of October. I think the Pixel 5 would be a good phone, a good well-made phone. And yep, that's all for the video. And if you like the video, please like the video and also subscribe to the channel to see more better awesome contents. And also do visit my blog, which is thedailyenterprise.com. And thank you for watching, and talk to you guys next video. Bye bye.